Welcome to our morning yoga practice. We are just coming onto our mat, settling in, making our space. We probably have another 2 minutes to go. So it's a great time to grab anything you'd like to incorporate into your practice, a blanket, a block, a strap, a cup of water, just anything you may want nearby. Then once you have your space set up, you can just settle in. Taking a few moments to just quietly center the mind or invite the movement into the body. We are going to begin standing up today, so just a heads up on that one. Probably another minute or so still to go. We're just making our way to the mat, settling in, getting comfy. Use this time to quiet the mind or to invite gentle movements. We're nearing our start. So if you are down on the mat, you're laying, if you're seated, go ahead and rise up. We're going to all meet in a nice standing posture.
You can be somewhere in the middle or front third of the mat. Probably facing the short end, I'm going to begin facing you guys. Set the feet hip-width distance or even a little wider than that. Maybe shift the weight around a little. Start to feel out all the corners of the feet before finding that nice foundation. The toes are down, the heels are rooted, the balls of the feet are in the mat. You can feel that grounding as you start to draw awareness up. Check in with the ankles. See how they're feeling today. Keep a little ease in the knees. Keep bringing awareness up as we stand tall, letting the tailbone drop down. Draw the gaze forward. Maybe a little reach of the crown of the head, slight tuck of the chin. Shoulders melt away from the ears as the arms rest by our side. Take a nice big inhale and exhale. Just feel the ribs expanding and contracting. Gentle lift of the body and release. Breathe in and out through the nose as best you can. My breath pace may be slightly different than yours, so just go what feels good for you, taking nice full inhales and exhales, that nice round of breath. Try to keep that nice rhythm as we add movement. Inhale the arms up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Nice big inhale as we reach. Exhale, hands to heart center. Big breath as we open the arms. Reach tall, lengthening side body. Exhale, hands to heart. Breathing as we reach up. Exhale, hands to heart center. We'll add a little more as we inhale up. pause with the hands overhead. Maybe interlace the fingers here. And we'll gently tick-tock left and right. Steady movement. Shift the weight from side to side. The feet stay planted. But move the hips a bit. You feel that weight moving to that outer foot. Nice way to check in with your awareness on that foundation. Sweep deep in the stretch through side body. We'll slow it down, come back to center, release the hands, let them float down to side body. We'll do little circles with the shoulders. You can start forward or backward. Growing that circle a little larger. And then pause, settle, and reverse. So if you went forward, go backward. If you went backward, go forward. And same thing, gently grow those circles, moving at your own pace here. Down, settle the arms, inhale as we reach up, exhale as we float all the way down to a forward fold. So the hands can reach to the earth, they can grab opposite elbows to hang in ragdoll, we'll keep a little bend at the knee. One more breath here. Holding elbows, release the hands. We'll generously bend the knees, lower the hips, belly to thighs. Gently root down and rise up. Back to our Tadasana. We'll bring left hand to left hip as we inhale up the right. Exhale as we take it over, shift the weight to that right foot, press through the right hip. You can leave the left foot on the ground. You can point those toes as we come into our crescent moon. Bring that hand to the hip, left arm long at our side, we're standing tall as we inhale up, exhale over. Again, shift the weight, press through the left hip, maybe the right toes point. Try to keep the heart open to the wall in front of you, and there's a little ease in that upper left arm. Exhale, left hand down. Shake out the arms. We're going to take the feet slightly wider than hip width distance. Softness in the knees, a little softness in the hips. Arms are loose at our side as we start to twirl. So we're just inviting a little twist. Let the arms kind of knock into the body. And the feet may lift up here, coming onto the balls. And then you can take that step even wider. Kind of finding what works for your body this morning. So we do these gentle twists to open up the ribs, the hips. Remember softness in the knees. The feet can lift. Listen to your joints. Maybe the gaze travels with you here. A little dizzy, you can keep that gaze forward. We'll take two more breaths here. Slowing it down. Coming back to our neutral. Move those feet back to our hip width distance. Nice big inhale as we reach up. Exhale. Exhale as we forward fold. Taking a breath here. Weight sitting in the front half, foot.
We'll start to strengthen the core and the back as we come to half lift. Our seven shape, hands to shins or thighs, navel drawing in toward the spine. And release. Lower the hips, that belly to thighs, root down,
and rise up.
Nice, and let's shift to the front of my mat, just turning my direction. You guys can stay where you're at. As we begin to move this into a sun A, so we're gonna take it nice and slow. We might have a few modifications, but that's generally where we're headed. So from our Tadasana, we inhale the arms up, exhale as we forward fold. We'll take a breath here. Inhale up to half lift, flat back, shoulders move away from the ears. Exhale as you release. Plant the hands, step one foot back and then the other, coming to your high plank. You can come onto the knees here if you like to. The fingers are spread wide, the heart is lifted, feeling nice and strong through the arms. Start to lower down. Coming to the belly, we put the chin down, uncurl the toes. And this is where we'll take some of those modifications, a little deviation. Inhale, baby cobra. So not too much weight in the hands here. Maybe you can drum out the fingers, lifting chin and collarbone. Exhale down, take a breath. Put a little more weight into the hands as we inhale up chin, collarbone, maybe a rib or two, deepening that stretch to the front midline. Relax the glutes. Lower down. Take a breath. On our next lift, yogi's choice, you can go to that middle lift or your baby cobra. As we inhale up, not going all the way up yet as we're still warming up the body. Exhale as you release. Take a breath. And curl the toes. Press up to an extended tabletop. So while I won't always call the extended tabletop, know that it's always available for you as a transition. Root into the hands, solid through the feet as we lift the knees. Make any little adjustments you need to as you come into down dog. So that's our upside down V shape. Our first one of the class. Feel free to explore. You can shift the hips, pedal the feet, bend the knees, or hold in stillness. Find a flat back as best you can. And settle in. On an inhale, we'll look toward the hands. Exhale as we bring the feet to meet them. Find yourself in forward fold. We'll take a breath. On your next inhale, half lift, strong back. Ooh, I need to adjust a little close to the furniture. Exhale as you release. Nice big inhale draws us up. And we exhale, hands to heart center. Take a breath here before we move into that again. Reminder, we will be doing some modifications. Big inhale up. Exhale.
exhale to forward fold. Walk the hands over to the right. Keep a little softness in the knees here. And then walk the hands over to the left. Back to center. Inhale, half lift. Maybe try a different variation with the hands here. If you're on shins, maybe go to thighs. You could try airplane arms. On an exhale, release. Another modification coming as we plant the hands, step just the right toes back, coming into our runner's lunge. Make any little adjustments you need to. We want to stack that bone, knee over ankle or just behind it for the left side, giving us a nice support as we sit the hips low, lengthen the spine, the gaze is at the mat. Lower the right knee, plant the right hand into the mat, draw the left fingers up, little twist. Exhale as you release the left hand down. Lift the right knee. Solid foundation as you step the left hands back. High plank as we take a breath. Lower down. Coming to the belly, we uncurl the toes. Inhale up, baby cobra or that middle lift. Exhale as you release. Curl the toes. Extended tabletop. Solid foundation as we lift the knees. Coming to our down dog. Take a few breaths here. And inhale, look forward. Exhale, feet to hands. Forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale as you release. Modification coming. Plant the hands. Slide the left toes back. So we're going to even out the sides here. Runner's lunge, hips are low, back leg is engaged. We have that nice stack on the right side. Awareness on the hips. Keep the breath steady. Lower the left knee, plant the left hand into the mat. It's in line with the back knee and the front foot, making a nice L as we draw the right hand up, twisting through the ribs as best we can. If having the right arm reaching up doesn't serve you, you could always take it to hip too as you turn the gaze up maybe. So there's some options, not here long. Exhale as you unwind. Plant both hands, lift the left knee off, foundation as we step it back, high plank. And anytime we're in high plank, knees can lower. Feeling strong as we use the triceps to gently lower us down. Uncurl the toes, baby cobra or that middle lift. Strong back, the tops of the feet stay connected to the mat. Exhale as you release. Curl the toes. Press through the hands up and back. Down dog.
hands. Exhale.
As you find yourself in forward fold, take a breath. Inhale, half lift. Exhale as you release. Soften the knees. Big inhale as we rise up. Scoop the air around you. Reach it tall. Exhale, hands to heart center. Nice work. Moving into it again with some modifications. Inhale the arms up. We'll take a little back bend at the top. Arching back. And lifting up. Exhale as you forward fold. We'll plant the left hand under the head on the mat, or if you have a block, or you can also hold on to a piece of furniture nearby to do this. We'll take a generous bend in that left knee as we rotate and reach the right arm up. Feel that twist through the ribs. Notice if the body's not moving, it's just the arm. Try to rotate there through the core. Exhale as we unwind. Swap hands. Right hand goes to that spot on the mat. Or it can go to a piece of furniture. You could do this with more of a flat back. We're going to bend the right knee. Twist left arm up. So this is what the modification might look like. That wall in front of you you're holding to, you have a block. Finding what works for you this morning. Unwind. Back to that forward fold. Take a breath. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, release. Plant the hands. Step them back. High plank. Lower down. Coming on to the belly, we'll inhale up, elbows under shoulders, Sphinx pose. So a variation on our cobra here. The hips are settled. Little ease in the legs. Spine is long. Try not to collapse into the shoulders here. We want to press into those elbows. That nice little lift. Into the hands, elbows go wide, favorite cheek into the mat, letting gravity help us loosen the neck a bit, and then swap sides, opposite cheek goes into the mat, relax the shoulders, turn the chin to center, bring hands under shoulders, curl the toes, and remember that transition if you want it, and we'll press up and meet in down dog. Forward, exhale the feet to hands, nice forward fold, inhale half lift, exhale release, use your inhale to lift up, reach it tall, and exhale hands to heart center. We'll move into that again, new modifications, inhale the arms up. Exhale as you forward fold. Inhale to half lift. Exhale, release. Plant the hands, step the feet back. We're in plank. Here's where our modification comes in this time. High plank. We're going to lower the left knee. Start to rotate the body. We're coming onto the inner blade or planting the sole of the right foot. As we open up, you can maybe bring hand to hip here.
a nice supported side plank. You could reach that arm up. If you're feeling super steady today, you could try and fly the right foot a bit. Definitely not feeling it today, so I'm going to keep that nice grounding. We'll take one more breath here. Gently unwind as we bring right hand back to the mat. Bring on the ball of the right foot, step the left toes back, high plank, strong arms, lower the right knee. Start to shift that way. We're rotating the body. Again, inner blade of the left foot or that sole can be all the way down. We're trying to stack the hips a bit here. May need to make some adjustments to have a nice support through that lower arm. Right arm or left arm can reach. Or you can go hand to hip. Each side might be a little different. So feel free to explore. Unwind. Left hand to mat, ball of the left foot down. We step the right toes back, high plank, and lower down. Uncurl the toes, and as you inhale, feel free to find your cobra. That could be baby cobra, mid-lift. You could head all the way to up dog. Exhale as you release. Curl the toes. Press the hips up and back, down dog. We'll root into the hands and the ball of the left foot as we draw the right foot up. And do a little core work here. Right knee to right elbow. Hover that foot, press it back. Right knee to left elbow, little twist, press it back, knee to nose, press it back. Maybe open the hips a little here, let that foot dangle. You could head to wild thing, or you could drop right foot and head back to your down dog. Root through the left or right toes as left foot lifts. And we do that same sequence. Left knee, left elbow. Press it back. Left knee, right elbow. Press it back. Knee to nose. We're moving into that plank position. Press it back. Open the hips. Drop that foot. Again, options, I'm going to square back up, drop the foot. My shoulders are a little swirly this morning. From here, we'll lower to the knees, uncurl the toes. Settle hips to heels, child's pose. Let the shoulders be at ease. To make a little pillow with the hands or the fists. Taking just one more breath here. We'll send the hands back overhead. Palms in the mat as we lift up. Find a neutral tabletop. Extend it out by moving the hands forward about a handprint each. Curl the toes, lift the hips, down dog. Inhale, the gaze forward. Exhale, the feet to the hands. Inhale, half lift. We're finishing out that last Sun A variation. Exhale as you release. Big inhale up. And exhale, hands to heart center. Nice work. Now, however you'd like to, we'll journey down onto the mat, coming to a seated position. Whatever that looks like for you today. centering in. We'll bring hands to heart center, pressing the palms together, thumbs to heart. So we sit up tall, shoulders drop away from the ears. Let the left ear fall toward the left shoulder. Inhale back to center and opposite side. Notice if the shoulders start to creep up here, if they tense. Use that exhale to let them settle a bit more, to invite in some ease. We'll bring head back to our neutral. Look over the left shoulder and then the right. Once more, a gentle movement. Back to center. Follow the gaze up to the sky, a lift of the heart, and back to neutral, rounding out our practice, just a little extra stretch there for the neck, helping to loosen after the shoulders did so much work. I appreciate you joining me in our practice today. I encourage you to take kind thoughts, kind words, and kind intentions with you from now until we meet again. The light in me honors the light in you. Namaste. Namaste. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you had some fun. I hope you explored that sun A and some ways that you can adapt it and make it your own. Have a little fun with your practice. I'll see you next week, next Tuesday morning. Have a great one until then. Bye, everyone.